What do they do? Okay.
That's what gamers think. But let me try to find out from the people who actually work in the gaming industry in Malaysia.
I guess most people think they play games all the time. In my previous company, you have to work very long hours. I will stay until like 11 PM to 1 AM.
Most of the time, client wants to see fast results. For a gaming production, it doesn't go from A to C immediately.
And one of the worst things is that there are places where the crunch is just normalized because they believe it's my duty as like an employee of the company.
Well, that doesn't sound like fun. Is it the same for game studios in other countries? Is the poor work-life balance the norm for us Malaysians, or are we the exception?
I heard what you were saying. I can answer that for you, in fact, because I'm the program manager at 11, the game studio in the UK that brought Rust from PC to console.
That's actually quite interesting. So how's it like working at a game development studio in the UK?
It's like an airy place filled with really talented, brilliant people.
Hold on. Before we go on, do you think it'll be better if we could do it somewhere more appropriate?
Yeah, sure. That's a good idea, actually.
So we try and create a versatile space. Like, we believe in that, but we will avoid crunch. We will avoid overworking. That's why we have like flexible start times for people. So if you were in late, then don't start as early the next day, or giving people time back when they travel, things like that. So we try not to have too many hard and fast rules as much as we have kind of principles around which we arrange things. The principle is being fair to people and, you know, creating a sustainable environment for doing great creative work. We've proven that we can deliver great games to our partners without burning out and beasting the team. So that's one of the biggest benefits, I think, is that, you know, we have a track record. And I think the benefit to us, like as a business, is obvious. Like, if you don't burn people out, they don't feel like they need to take a break or a career break, or, you know, maybe leave games entirely because they come to not love it in the way that maybe they once did. And I think another benefit is really, we're very open. We have some values that we want to adhere to. And if you think we're not meeting them, then talk to us about it.
Well, that all sounds promising, but I want to hear it from other 11 employees themselves.
We do have flexible working hours, that's for sure. We do have a lot of employee benefits as well. One of the things that I really like that we've started doing recently is the sort of family outings that we do once a month. So we go out somewhere, amusement park, or just for a hike.
One of the things that 11 does to prioritize our mental health is that we keep regular check-in with our colleagues, but we also have access to an external service which offers us free counseling, which we would usually get long waiting times for, and that way we get quick help when we need it.
I remember viscerally, whilst I was an intern, on Sunday evening, thinking to myself, you know, I really can't wait to get in tomorrow. Because I was so happy with my project, I was so happy with my team.
I've been at 11 for 2 years. I joined as a senior and I'm already a lead. So there's enough pathways and checks by your seniors and the people around you to ensure that there is career progression happening for both you and for the people around you.
If you're enthusiastic, you know, if you're slightly creative, you're interested in the craft, I think it really helps to like to love the thing that you're working on and love the thing you're making. Then the games industry as a whole is probably a great place for you to be.
So I noticed that 11 actually has a new office in Malaysia.
We do. We opened in May last year officially. It's a tremendous space. You should go and see it sometime.
Actually, hey, look, it's 11's studio. Let's go.
Ian wasn't able to be at the office, so we met up with one of the Malaysian team members, Emil.
Let me show you around.
I heard in the UK they have like pretty sweet perks and benefits. Do you get those here as well?
Oh yeah, absolutely. We've got stuff like flexi hours, things like mental health care.
So I see you have a lot of development rooms.
Yeah, each development room is kind of segmented into different projects that we're working on at any given time. But a meeting room over here, we're able to talk to the UK side of the teams. A library for some R&R, we got some books for inspiration that cover all sorts of facets. So we've got a build review room here. So we want to come here and basically get together and take a look at the latest progress on any given build at a given time. So, you know, chill.
Right, okay. So this the cinema room, and wow, okay, it looks gorgeous.
Occasionally we'll have like a showcase going on for what's going on with 11 and watch through certain things together.
I see there's one more room behind. Do you think that we could check it out?
Oh, slow your roll there, cowboy. We've got a couple of things there that's not quite ready for the public eye. This is my start, but I tell you what, if you want a sneak peek at what we've got, Malaysians, I want to hear from you. Coders, artists, you name it. Anyone in the games industry, you got the skills to pay the bills, we would love to hear from everybody. Please check out our website for some openings.
Right, thank you Emil for showing us around your office. Thank you Double 11 for having us at your office. So I'm done, right? I'm done? I don't have to do an interview anymore? You want to play some games?
My brother, let's get it!
Yeah, let's go!
Let's go.